Welcome to Unfiltered from Home. I'm SE Cupp. Joe Biden has been accused of sexual assault by a former staffer named Tara Reade. She alleges that in 1993, while she was working for the then senator, he sexually assaulted her in a hallway. Now, Joe Biden denies the allegations and went on MSNBC to finally address them himself. Here is what he said.
No, it is not true. I'm saying unequivocally, it never, never happened, and it didn't. It never happened.
Today, I'm joined by Congressman Eric Swalwell. Welcome, Congressman. I thought that interview by Mika Brzezinski was a very tough one. You know, as tough as they come, she did a great job. She asked him over and over again, not only about the allegation itself, but about the seeming double standard that in some cases we're meant to believe all women, in others we're not meant to. What did you make of Biden's responses in that interview?
Well, you know, first, the default is women should be believed. Of course, other evidence, you know, should be considered. And the vice president, he's a public figure. It comes with the job, is answering questions like this when allegations are made. And I thought, you know, he came across in a dignified way. He did not question her motives. He didn't call her a liar. He didn't say that she's not his type, and he didn't threaten to sue her, which is in contrast to the president, who's been accused by at least 25 women. But he did offer to provide records, if there were any, around her employment in his office. And I think transparency is going to be important because it's so long ago, any records that could help inform what happened is going to be important.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned Trump. We don't have a smoking gun. And unlike, you know, President Trump's case, where you had multiple women corroborating a pattern of behavior, here we have one woman alleging that she was sexually assaulted by Joe Biden. So how do you think we should judge this story?
Yeah, and one, if true, SE, is not acceptable. But you did what the president, as you pointed out. You not only had multiple women, you had the president admitting to that type of conduct on the Access Hollywood tape that was released. So there's a lot of factors. Yes, whether there's a pattern of conduct, I found is a sexual, when I did sexual assault cases as a prosecutor, that oftentimes, you know, it wasn't just one incident or one victim that the more you would investigate, the more you would find. And so, you know, she's going to be interviewed, I understand, this weekend by another you know, journalist. And I think the American people deserve to, you know, hear the evidence here. And the vice president, I'm going to take him at his word that he's going to, you know, try and find any records if they're out there. And that will inform us as to, the, you know, whether there's any truth in the allegation.
Yeah. And in some ways, I think Brett Kavanaugh might be the better comparison than Donald Trump. You have to acknowledge, I think, that there's politics at play in some of these issues. Certainly, many of the people calling to not confirm Brett Kavanaugh to the Supreme Court were on the left. They didn't like his politics. They didn't support the president. The Tara Reade story was initially sort of promoted by Bernie Sanders supporters. Now, she herself is a Democrat. I don't suggest that she is politically motivated here, but how do we as voters sift through all of that?
It's a great question, Essie. And, you know, I think it shows, you know, how difficult allegations like these are. One, if it's true for her, again, that has to be, you know, sorted out. Two, you know, now this is not the Senate confirming a Supreme Court judge. You know, it's really going to be up to the voters. The voters are going to be the individual judges as they look at the evidence. And I think what the vice president did today is what an innocent person would do, which is to, you know, put his account out there, not question the motives of somebody else, but also to pledge if he has any information that could aid in deciding, you know, the credibility of this allegation, that he will provide it. I think that's what an innocent person would do. And I always, you know, as a former prosecutor, I like to think, like, if I was accused of something, you know, how would I have acted if I was questioned, you know, by a police officer or in this case, you know, by a public jury? And I think what we saw today from the vice president is what somebody would do if they truly believe they did not do this.
I have to tell you, it's been a little odd to see women Democrats so definitively declare Biden's innocence. You know, Stacey Abrams, who very much wants to be Joe Biden's veep, says she believes Biden, that this did not happen. Nancy Pelosi, Kirsten Gillibrand, Kamala Harris, all have defended Biden. Do you worry that that will ding their credibility a bit when issues like this are raised against, you know, political opponents?
I guess, SC, I would say, I would follow what Biden said, which is he believes the default is you believe the woman. If someone's making a serious allegation like this, you should believe that person. And then you should consider other evidence that's out there. And the vice president is denying that this happened. He's offering, you know, to cooperate and provide any evidence that would help her make the case if that's true. And I think that is still the default, is that you should believe the woman until other evidence comes in. And we're starting to see other evidence come in. I'm really looking forward to seeing and hearing from Ms. Reade this weekend as she's interviewed. I think that will help the American people sort this out. I mean, there's nothing easy about this. And yeah. If it's true, I'm sorry that it happened. If it's not true, again, I think I'm just sorry for the country that, you know, we are, talking about this, but it has to be resolved. We're public figures. The vice president is, you know, an honorable person, and, you know, he has to answer these questions. And I think it was a good thing today that he came out and started that process.
Do you think he needs to do more? Does he need to sit down for more interviews, answer more questions?
I think he should be transparent. I don't think he should run away from the issue or believe that, it's going away. And I think he will. You know, the other unfortunate part of all of this, in the COVID crisis, you know, he couldn't have a face-to-face interview with a reporter. I think that would have been interesting to see. That's not his fault. That's not the reporter's fault. That's just the nature. But I think more humanity would have come out. And the same for Ms. Reade. She's not going to get a face-to-face interview either. And that's just the nature of where we are right now.
So you mentioned, you know, this will be up to voters. I agree. The way that works is plenty decided that all of the allegations against Trump did not matter. They voted for him anyway. Do you think voters will decide to compartmentalize this? Maybe because, you know, getting Trump out of office for a lot of voters is the priority.
Well, I think the American people right now, first and foremost, are worried about this pandemic, what it means to their health, what it means to the economy, paying their bills, and they want a leader in this crisis. And everything I know about the vice president is that he is an honorable person. He's an experienced leader. He knows when he doesn't know the answer and who to go to. And those are all the qualities that you want in a president going forward. And I think also how he handles himself with this allegation will tell us a lot about just his character and who he is. And so, you know, again, we're electing someone for the highest office at the most perilous time in the last 100 years. It's important that people who run for office like this are tested, especially when an allegation like this is made. And if it turns out to not be true, I think you will have an even more resilient President Biden.
So at this point, are you comfortable supporting Joe Biden?
Yes. I say that saying that at this point, my default is Ms. Reade has made an allegation. We should believe her. We should investigate it. If the person accused is denying it, we should weigh that evidence. And I'm going to do all that. But right now, yes, I am.
Congressman Eric Swalwell, thanks so much for joining me today.
Of course.
Stay safe.
My pleasure. Thanks, Essie. You too.